Still tracking some heavy rain that continues to be all across the viewing area, for that matter. Chief Meteorologist Bryan Busby here in the First Alert Weather Center. This is Storm View Doppler radar. And with very few exceptions, most of it's a solid wall of water that continues to move toward us. You look at the oranges, those are the heavier downpours, slowing traffic down as we get closer and closer to the evening commute. Farther to the south, though, it looks like those are the better chances for all more isolated thunderstorms. And there is, toward the Lake of the Ozarks, a severe thunderstorm warning for maybe damaging winds and possible hail. But looking closer to the metro, it is still coming down in sheets, and it will continue to be that way for at least the next few hours or so. That's going to hamper traffic. A couple of our scout cameras to bear this fact out. This is going to be at 635 Wyandotte County, starting with the Kansas side first. It looks like that's one of those pockets of lighter rain. On the other side of state line, though, this is going to be toward Woods Chapel Road. Totally different matter. Look at that. We're talking no more than, what, 5 to 15 miles from either side, and you see the deluge of rain that's currently moving through, say, the eastern portion of Jackson County, heading toward Grain Valley and also Oak Grove. So this will be the band that's moving through right now with the orange centers on this side of state line. A little break for the time being, but we do look for redevelopment later on tonight. And don't forget, we're still under a flood watch until this thing moves out. And right now, the indications are Tuesday looks wet, Wednesday looks wet, maybe by Thursday it'll start to taper off, but not before dropping anywhere from 3 to 5 inches of rain. We'll continue to monitor the situation, but for now, that's the very latest from the First Alert Weather Center.
Stay connected to the team you trust for weather on KMBC.com.